All right, we're keeping it going. By the way, once again,
how do you spell that?
SOM. If you want to talk to Steve from I Wrestle the Bear Once, the number to call is 646-929-1357. That's our number, right? Yeah, I got to double check now. All right, let's take Chris. Chris, are you there, buddy? Chris? 504. Chris. Chris?
504. That's New Orleans.
Uh-oh. He's gone. He's too drunk. He's too drunk to do this.
Damn it. Do you guys remember the last time I called in and talked to you? I was in New Orleans, too drunk to call in and talk to you.
Yes, I do remember.
I think they get scared when I answer them.
Noah's doing some call screening. We want to know what your questions are before you get on the air. Very supportive, Sid. If anything,
ask a really normal question, and then when you actually get on the air, ask the really fucked up, weird thing you were thinking about asking.
We don't want to promote that. All right,
screening negated. No more need for that.
We have rollerblading fag on the line.
What?
That's me.
Nice.
To honor the memory of Seth Putnam, of course. What's going on, Steve? Brad?
Nothing. Now I'm just thinking about anal cunt, you know?
Me too.
If you know what I'm saying.
What was that your question for Steve? What's
up? I want to leave a comment for you. I wanted you to tell Krista Cameron that her voice makes me cum all over my body.
Mm. All over yourself? Not
all over myself. It fills the room.
All right. It's pretty perfect, man.
If you want to get some inspiration for that movie, if you want to get some inspiration for that movie, you got to watch the movie Eraserhead by David Lynch 4 times in a row. On Nutmeg.
Actually, you have to watch it on Laserdisc if you want the full experience. Just putting that out there. And you have to inject PCP into your dick hole to get the full effect.
Of course you do.
That guy was like Pizza
Destroyer's
father.
Spread the knowledge, people. Or Twin Peaks. You could also watch Twin Peaks if you had PCP injected into your dickle.
Thank you very much for the call, rollerblading fag.
Said with a straight face, man.
Well, I'm a professional.
Rob's never said anything with a straight face.
Come on. Come on.
I get it. It's right. Because he sucked my dick. That's why.
Right now we have Rod on the line. Rod, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Oh, very deep voice for Rod.
Hello, Rod.
Dude, that's Ron. That's fucking Ron. I recognize that voice anywhere.
Curious, you beautiful bastard, if you're coming back to Charleston, South Carolina anytime soon. And if you're not, I'm going to post your assless pic all over your internet.
Ass pics?
Well, you do have that. And Ron, I love you. This is Ron. He works for what used to be our favorite radio station in America, but not anymore, so fuck them.
Is it because you left?
Yeah, it's because you left. But I don't know. Charleston is one of the many assholes of the universe. I'm from one of them myself, so I feel like it's okay to call it that. And I have no fucking clue when are we coming back? You tell me. You book a show and we'll come play.
Boom. Make it happen.
Well, if you can make it to like 16th, that would be great.
Are we on tour then? If we're on tour, then
I do not know at the moment in time.
All right. Well, we're going to have to let you go.
Facebook me, bro.
You guys talk in private. Figure it out.
All right.
Someone book Iwabo.
Ooh, I'm having some acid.
Acid.
Do you need a Zantac?
You have any PCP in your dick right now?
A little acid reflux action going on. All right.
I just want to point out to Ron. Ron has the deepest, most amazing radio voice of all time. So that's
he does
that's
put
good.
Our voices to shame.
Well, yours.
Oh, come on. All right, let's take Freddie. Freddie, are you there?
Hollywood. I'm here, bud.
Okay. Freddie, you're on the line with Steven from I Wrestled a Bear Once. What is your question?
What is your weirdest run-in with a fan?
I don't know. We have quite a number of interesting ones. Probably in Japan, because we were sharing a bus with a band that people cared about, they were trying to, like, rock it over and flip it and shit. So that was pretty sweet.
Holy shit.
What band was that?
Never. Fact. They're a Japanese band.
Oh.
Let's see. When we played Russia, I, like, crowd surfed off the stage to do vodka shots at the bar. And then a man just open mouthed tried to tongue kiss me with no warning whatsoever.
Rob, come on.
I wasn't there.
Would it have been fine if there was a warning?
Let's see. All of my stories involve men trying to get at me. I have no good woman stories.
And all your callers have been gay so far, too.
I think Rob saw the show at South by. I dove into the crowd. And the biggest, burliest, I'm assuming, gay man of all time, I was crowd surfing, ripped my shirt off of me, and was just groping me inexplicably whilst I was on top of the crowd. And no one stopped him. It was pretty incredible.
Basically, you're the male Courtney Love with these crowd surfing finger bang stories.
Well, I didn't kill Kurt Cobain yet, but yeah.
Yet, I like that. Yeah.
Still have time.
Dig him up.
All right, let's once again, the number to call Steve. Time is running out, people, so you better do it soon. It's 646.
I gotta go through the Deftones, so you know, we gotta get going here.
Oh shit. We'll definitely make it happen.
I am going to see Deftones tonight.
Oh, cool.
So my life is instantly better than anyone else who lives in Southern California, and if you're going to see Deftones tonight.
So the number to call is 646-929-1357. And right now, let's take, I just had a caller, I don't understand. Alexis, are you there?
It's your sister.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello.
Oh,
You're on the air with Steven.
Oh, wow. What happened to the original members of the band? Like, in the Taste of Kevin Bacon video?
Oh,
like,
shit.
Ricky,
that's a real,
and
that's
Mikey
a real
are missing,
question.
And...
That's like a real question. Wow.
Yeah, this guy must be an actual fan.
That's a good question.
I am a
huge fan. I'm really shocked. Okay, our original drummer, Ryan, was out of the band like a month after we shot that video because he just didn't want to go on tour anymore and really do anything. Our keyboardist, pretty much the same thing. He was married and decided he didn't want to do music stuff. And basically, he never wrote anything. We just had him there to play stuff live. So we switched over to a click track, and now the computer plays all the little keyboard parts. And he also was out of the band, like, before we did the full length or anything. And our bass player in that video, Brian, got arrested with some Mary Jane on him. Oh. And in Louisiana, that's a crime punishable by death. He was in prison for, like, fucking 2 months and then got put on probation for 4 years to not leave the state. So that's why he is out of the band. And, yeah, like, literally the tour after we shot that video, we got Mikey and Ricky, and then, yeah.
Well,
there we go. That was a real answer to a real question. That just happened on this show. Professionalism for a change.
Kind of weird, right? Kind of weird.
The keyboardist was there when we interviewed you guys in the bathroom in New York, right? Our first interview with you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. It was beautiful.
Thanks for your question, Alexis. What?
He said something in Chinese.
Oh.
Kang Fing Hong.
Thanks for calling. All right, one last question. We have Taylor on the line. Taylor, are you there?
Hello?
Yes, you're on the air with Steven from I Wrestled a Bear Once.
Oh, shit. yeah, so how many times do you get laid on like, your daily tour?
Great question. Whatever? Great question.
Well, if you count the big burly guy in Austin, Texas that raped me whilst I was crowd surfing, then one. So I have been dating the same gal for almost a year. So, yeah, if she's on tour, then like a million times a day or whatever, like every day, all day. There's little Malaysian boys there watching, you know, touching my ass.
Nice.
But, yeah, if she's not there, I just... whack it in a truck stop bathroom and cry myself to sleep. It's pretty exciting life on the road.
There you have it. There you have it, Taylor.
So it's like to be in a quote-unquote real traveling touring band. You masturbate in Flying J bathrooms and cry yourself to sleep. Hope my mom's not listening.
Question.
Sorry, Mom.
Have you ever jizzed it into a Doritos bag?
I think there's like at least 3 members in our band that can say yes to that question.
But you're not one of them, or you are one of them?
No, I was trying to be mysterious, but yeah, okay, oh. I'm 2 of them.
See, it's not a rarity.
Oh, actually, we just talked about this. We were coming home from celebrating my birthday last week, and we were, of course, in our van because, like, we can't really afford cars or anything, so we drive the van around. And I had a piss really bad because, of course, I'm wasted. It's my birthday, and I'm old and sad. And I pissed in two, plastic coffee cups, like the ones that are meant to look like Starbucks cups, but like they're plastic and reusable or whatever, eco-friendly bullshit.
Sure.
Anyway, I pee in two of those and then wash them out. And the people that they belong to in my band don't want to use them after that. That seems weird to me. That's pee. That's sterile. Can anyone back me up that that's acceptable? Like, I would drink in a cup. I would drink out of a cup of raw piss in if you, like, cleaned it afterward.
Yeah, with some soap, that should be fine.
I don't know. Once it's been pissed in, it's done.
Some people pee in each other's mouths.
Damn it, that's...
Yeah, and you still kiss them.
See, you said exactly what our tour manager, Elizabeth Eli, he said, once it's been pissed in it, it's done. That's literally exactly what he said. You guys should go out.
And what's his
other
number? All right, yeah. We have one last caller, one final entry. Let's take it right now. Amber, I hope it's a girl. Amber? Sir?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay, it is a girl. All right, our first female caller for Steve from I Wrestle the Bear Once. You're on the air with Amber. Amber, say hello. Amber, Steve.
Hi.
Steve, Amber.
What's up?
Nothing. I was just calling to ask if you'd ever met Haley Williams.
Oh, my God.
No, I have not. You'd be surprised. That's not the first time someone's asked me that. They,
who is Haley
were
Williams?
We're on Warped Tour last year. That's the only time. It's like a Paramore. Who just said, who's Haley Williams? Get the fuck out of here. How old are you? Come on.
I'm 27.
I'm 17.
There you go.
No, I mean the person who didn't know who Haley Williams is, because everyone knows who Haley Williams is. Come on now.
Sorry, I'm an old man.
But anyway... I have not. I would high five her though.
Have you ever met the chick from Evanescence?
Really?
This is a true story. This is a true story. That's pretty awesome. My band, like 8 years ago, like forever ago, we played with Evanescence in a shithole bar in Bossier City, Louisiana. I guess it was like 10 years ago. It was right before they blew up. There's like 15 people there, and they were fucking smashed, wasted. And so were we, and it was a good old time. They were friendly. Point being, I think I met her, but we're all super.
Have you ever
hammered.
Met Pat Benatar?
Yes. I actually did a collab with Pat Benatar on the latest Pat Benatar record. You might have not heard of it, so that's how you don't know if I'm telling the truth
I'm
or not.
I'm going to go on iTunes and check.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
It's actually under the Stephen J. Bradley Experience featuring Pat Benatar.
Thanks.
All right. Thank you so much, Stephen, for calling in and taking some time to talk to your fans and us here on the live cast. Hope you enjoy that.
Anytime. I'm going to go see Deftones.
Yeah,
so I can cry and sing along.
If Haley Williams is there, say hi.
And
I will.
And a quick plug for Stephen's band's new album, I Wrestle the Bear Once, is Ruining It for Everybody. Comes out July 26th on Century Media Records. Is it going to be good, Steven? Or is it going to be like, eh?
Well, truth be told, the last record, immediately after we recorded it, we all really hated. And this one we all really love. So I don't know if that's a good sign or a bad sign.
It
so,
might be a good sign.
That.
Well,
that's
right.
A quote. That's the headline right there.
It contains two black metal riffs, just so everyone remembers.
So make sure to pick up.
Yeah, actually... One of the sweetest, heaviest riffs of the record that's all just, like, sweeping and arpeggios and gravity blasts and, like, gutturals, it's a true story, is immediately followed by a part with a gospel choir on it, which is legit. We recorded them in Atlanta, and it's amazing. So there you go. That's the new album in a nutshell.
Great. Well, we're going to listen to a little sample
so
of
the
it
worst,
right now.
Worst thing ever, ruining it for everybody.
Ruining It for Everybody comes out July 26th. Here's a track, Karate Nipples.
Fake.
Real.
It's about Rob.
It's about me. Exclusive. Right here on the live cast. Thanks again, Steven.
Yeah, thank you. Later.
Later.